Good morning, children. I hope you all are doing well. Today we are going to study a poem, Old Mr. Laughter by Edgar Guest. Before we start the poem, we are going to know a little about the poet. Edgar Guest was born in England, but later he took the citizenship of America. So he is also called an English-American poet. Most of his works are based on common people. Means he usually write on people, the common people, life and happiness, sorrow. He is also called an optimistic poet. Optimistic means a person who is full of life. A person who is full of life, who is full of hope. Hopeful person is called an optimistic person, and this can be easily seen in his works. That is the reason why he is also called people's poet, because his major works are based upon common people. Now once again, children, before we start the poem, I would like to bring your notice towards these things. You see here, G is missing. Grinning, it should be grinning. Signing, it should be signing. Morning, it should be morning. This is the informal way of conversation in some parts of America and England. But it is wrong. You cannot use this way. You cannot write grinning this way. You have to write the full word. Alright, so let us begin with the poem. Old Mr. Laughter comes a-grinning down the way, singing, never mind your troubles, for they'll surely pass away. Singing, now the sun is shining, and there's roses everywhere. Tomorrow will be soon enough to fret about your care. So, poet here explains about a man, an old man, who comes down the way, down the lane every day, and through his posture only, children, we can know that he is a very jolly person, very happy person. So old Mr., he has named him Old Mr. Laughter. So this Old Mr. Laughter comes every day down the way, down the lane, and he is what? He's smiling, he's grinning every day. Singing, never mind your troubles. And he sings a song. He sings a song that never mind your troubles. Don't keep thinking about your bothersome life. Don't bother much about your troubles in your life. For they'll surely pass away. Means all your troubles that you have today is not going to last forever. It is not that good times remains always, neither the bad ones. Everything shall pass. This now suppose we have this critical situation of corona, COVID, and this will also not last forever. This also shall pass one day. We can relate it, isn't it? Singing, now the sun is shining and there's roses everywhere. He sings that now today is the life. Today the sun is bright. Your life is full of so many small happiness to be noticed. And there are roses everywhere. Means here I think the poet is referring to the people, the loved one you have around. Your friend, your family, your colleagues, and the people whom you love. They are there with you. So why you are so bothersome about your worries, about your tensions? Just live your life today, he says. Tomorrow will be soon enough to fret about your care. Tomorrow you will have enough time. You will have enough time to think about your future. Tomorrow you will have enough time to think about your worries. Just live today. The moment now is life, he says.